With a massive buildup of Russian troops near Ukraine's shared border and U.S. intelligence indicating an invasion of Ukraine could happen early next year, U.S. President Biden met virtually with Russian President Vladimir Putin.
Good to see you again.
The pair spoke for 2 hours. Putin denies Russia intends to invade Ukraine, calling it fear-mongering. But the U.S. president made clear today that if Russia did, tough economic sanctions would follow.
I will look you in the eye and tell you, as President Biden looked President Putin in the eye and told him today, that things we did not do in 2014, we are prepared to do now.
That reference is to the Russian annexation of Crimea from Ukraine that prompted U.S. sanctions. Biden also told Putin the U.S. was prepared to assist militarily.
We would provide additional defensive materiel to the Ukrainians above and beyond that which we are already providing. And we would fortify our NATO allies on the eastern flank.
For its part, Russia is seeking assurances from the West that Ukraine will not become a member of the North Atlantic Treaty Organization, something the Ukrainians have pursued for years. The U.S. National Security Advisor reiterated Ukraine can associate with whomever it wants. But one analyst believes joining NATO is unrealistic.
It ought to be clearer to them that we're not coming to the rescue, so you're going to have to live with next to Russia without a U.S. security guarantee.
There were also questions about the controversial Nord Stream 2 pipeline, which runs from Germany to Russia, and whether it could be used as leverage in discussions over Ukraine. The White House says it will pressure the German government to stop it if Russia invades. The Biden administration will continue to work with its European partners, promising a coordinated response should Russia ignore their warnings. President Biden will also speak with Ukraine's President Zelensky on Thursday. Kimberly Halkett, Al Jazeera, The White House.